Lord. So far today, am I doing all right? I have not gossiped, lost my temper, been greedy, grumpy, nasty, selfish, or even self-indulgent. I have not whined, complained, cursed, or eaten any chocolate. I have not charged anything on my credit card. But I will be getting out of bed in a minute, and then I think I will really need your help. I'm sure all of us can feel the same way. Now, how many of you have been faced with death of some kind? Almost all of us. I'm probably the oldest one here in the class today. I can honestly tell you that 50 years ago, death was different than it is now. So, how can we adapt to the change? I'm going to give you 8 tips to avoid identity theft. No, you don't need to buy a membership. You see them advertised on TV and they're cleaning up. But that doesn't solve the problem. Tip number 1, seal your lips. That means you never, ever give your social security number or personal information of any kind over the telephone or online unless you call them. Now, did you know that if somebody has your social security number and your driver's license number, they can find out more information about you than you can find out yourself? That's really true. I never carry a driver's license with me. I hear people that say, "Oh, that's wrong. You're going to get a ticket." No, because all the policemen have computers. And all I do is just say, "Hey, for my protection, I don't carry it. But what I do carry is my passport, which has picture ID on it." What's the difference between a passport and a driver's license? A lot. Because if someone uses your driver's license and your social security and they steal money out of one of your accounts, you got to go through a lot of HEQ. What do they have to go through? Cotton picking attorney, plea bargains it down to a misdemeanor. Didn't help you one bit. However, if all you do is use your passport, now that's federal. And the federal boys don't mess around with them. They don't do all this stuff they do in the state. You are going to jail. That's why that I carry my passport with me at all times, and I don't carry a driver's license on me. I keep it in a good place. Next, shred bank and credit card statements. Cancel checks. Pre-approved credit cards is a no-no. Get rid of them. If you need some credit, go to your established places that you do business and they'll work with you. In fact, they're easier to work with than some of these cotton picking pre-approved credit cards. Now, we also have a lot of mail that we got coming out now that is hurting us. Now, next one is guard your mail. Because most of us are in the habit of just putting letters in there, fold it, let the mail, put up the flag, and the mailman stops. Well, I've had several thefts on my street, so where I had my shop, I have a secured mailbox. Gotta have a key to get in and get stuff out. I cut out all them thefts. So when you pay your bills, don't put them in your mailbox. Use a locked mailbox or take it down to the post office. Now, the next one there that I skipped over is checking your credit reports. Now, you need to look for telltale markers of identity theft. And example, if they get a hold of your account, they can write checks on your account. Now, if you carry insurance, you only got a small deductible like $50 or $100 that you got to pay out of your pocket, and they have to take care of the rest. But there's an awful lot of mirage that you have to go through to get it done. It's not an easy thing to sit down and write out some forms. No, it's a lot worse than that. I've had my identity stolen twice, and I've had stuff stolen from me, more fingers and toes than I have. And I can honestly tell you, it is pure hell. Now, next one. Whoops, I'm going backwards. Sheesh. Okay, synchronize your bank statements. As soon as you get your bank statement in the mail, or a lot of them, you're doing it online now. My wife has an account and everything is done through email. I don't like that. I want to see paper. So I have my receipt that I have a locked mailbox. And that's where it goes. It doesn't go to my house. You need to monitor your checking account. And don't leave blank checks around. Because somebody else sees it. And particularly with your credit cards, be careful how you use them, because they can just drive down the street, they got a machine now, and ding, 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 ding. And they got everybody's stuff that is there just laying around. So you have to scrutinize your bank statements. You need to be careful of the ATMs, because somebody is going to be looking around and just to see what they can see, and maybe you'll catch it, and maybe you won't. Also, be careful with your PIN numbers. Okay. If you use the computer a lot, almost every one of you here probably do, you need to use a firewall. And there are several of them around that you can buy. Okay, next one is memorize. Do not write down PIN numbers. Passwords. Commit them to your memory. Now, one other thing that makes it easier for you, harder for someone else, you need to have 6 letters or numbers or more. And if you take one from the upper slot, if you have 9 different digits up there, not a number, but different symbols, and you can put that in your password, and it makes it a lot tougher for someone else to do it. Copy everything in your wallet. Write it down and put that in a secure place, either in your desk or in a safe deposit box, whatever you want to do, and that way nobody else can get at it. Okay? So the 8 tips were, number 1, sear your lips. Number 2, shred pre-approval. Number 3, guard your mailbox. Number 4, check credit cards. Number 5, scrutinize your bank accounts. Number 6, build a firewall. Number 7, memorize all your important data. And number 8, copy everything that's in your wallet. Now, if you never fail, you haven't quit trying. But if you quit trying, that's when you become a quitter. It's a Toastmaster.